Let's check out John Tiller's Panzer Campaign, Scheldt 44. It was just released and we will do a feature overview and also a tutorial play in order to showcase this game. Yeah, give me a moment to get into my chat and then we will dive into it. Sound check. Okay, as usual, I will do this video in two parts. First part, I will explain what it is and will provide an in-depth showcase of features, scenarios, involved units, and documentation. What you can expect to see when you buy it. And in the second part, we will play the tutorial. So some of you that are already familiar with Panzer campaigns, they might want to take a look at the first part. And yeah, good. Yeah, John Tiller software. Yeah, and thanks for letting me check it out. And yeah, John Tiller software offers different echelons of simulation. And yeah, you can check it out on the website of tactical battles, tactical commanding. It starts with squad battles, goes then up with panzer battles, which is already on the company echelon. And then you have panzer campaigns, which is focusing on the on true campaigns on the operational side of warfare. And that's where Scheldt is situated. Yeah, check out the website. For the English-speaking audience, they might know this battle as Battle of the Scheldt. Yeah, a lot of nationalities and units were involved. Late war, and the Germans or German-speaking audience might know it as a Schlacht an der Scheldemündung. Yeah, check out the background if you're interested. And yeah, there's also currently a winter sale going on. For all products that are older than 12 months, you will receive a discount until New Year. Okay, but before we dive into the game, as usual, I will provide an in-depth, because I personally would also know about this. So let's exit the game and see what you will attain if you buy the game. Yes, so it will come with a lot of documentation. There is a updated Panzer Campaigns user manual, check it out, containing information about how the simulation handles aspects and how to use it. I mean, in every Panzer Campaign game, including the specifics you might encounter in the specific titles. Yeah, we have the user manual of the Panzer campaigns. Then you have the starting documentation helping you to get into the game. That is also what I will use for the tutorial play and will follow it. It looks quite accessible, not too much text, a lot of pictures. Everything put into good, every step being highlighted in a paragraph. And this time they decided to, it seems to have several getting started scenarios, which I guess are linked together. I like it that they did this. So you can step by step evolve your learning. Good. As also what you know from other games, it comes with the ability to edit scenarios or to design your scenarios. It comes with a scenario editor, also with documentation for it. Also interesting, our OOB editor. And also with documentation for it. Then we have a parameters editor. You know, there are sometimes simulation aspects, values, where people have different opinions, different statements, and perhaps you and your opponent, if you play it multiplayer or if you play it single player, are considering something specific, needs to have different parameters, so you can access the parameter editor, which allows you to modify values, for example, how much a specific terrain will slow down a unit, how much movement points it will cost. So you have the power to modify it if you wish. You don't need to do it, but if you wish for, you can do it. Then you have a map editor where you can modify or create your maps, and it also comes with documentation. And yeah, one interesting document you are supplied with this time is this here, which basically gives you about every scenario. You will get in-depth information optionally to immerse yourself. You know, I'm often talking about that war games lacking the immersive aspect, and I think exactly like this, you see this, many put a lot of research into it, but it is not often visible. And here you can see what went into those scenarios, even provide with historical pictures and maps and further detail. I recommend you to check out those documents if you, I don't know, for example, want to play a scenario at Le Havre, that you might read it. Yeah, it helps to immerse yourself, and then you go into it. You also learn something about history while doing it. And if you don't have the time, simply play it. Yeah. Completely fine. What floats your boat? Yeah, very extensive document. This took some time to write. Yeah, beautiful. You can see what research went into this. So yeah, what scenarios can you expect? Let's quickly access the game before we take a look at the units. I of course obviously can't showcase all scenario, loading them would take too long. But as I usually do, you see a bracket of information here. The amount is this, quite some scenarios, yeah. And yeah, you pause the video if you see something, I don't know, Antwerp, you say, wow, I want to know more about it. You have here the information, pause the video and you can read it. And the scenarios, I will show it later when we get into the game, they range from scenarios which you might play in a short amount of time up to scenarios really for the hardcore wargamer who wants to really go deep into those operations. So there are situations you might rate as tactical engagements, even if this game is on an operational scale, they still provide you scenarios of different complexity and unit amount. So for everybody, something is there. Okay, yeah. It's difficult in a game like this to showcase what units are involved, but I find a way I think is pretty good by looking at the unit graphics. Here you see the nations that are involved. Let's go through them. And first let's check out the Americans, and I always do it like this. We won't talk about every unit, but it helps you to understand what you might expect in those games, what units you might see, what equipment you might see. Yeah, pause the video if you're interested to take a detailed look at this. So this was for the American units. Next, American Airborne, I guess. Yeah. And yeah, one thing I will always mention, looks like that here not, but for many folders, GTS provided you with alternate graphics, for example here. We won't go through all those options. Check them out yourself but I've already noticed it by checking myself that you have a lot of options to customize your game. So if you say, I don't know, I don't like those new unit pictures, you know, they upgraded their engine several times, and this also runs in the latest upgrade. You might think, yeah, I want it like old school, I want the classic. You might look at those folders and find it. So Airborne. Then we have the Belgians. A lot of nations this time participating in the operation. Even irregulars are depicted. The British. Churchill tanks, crocodiles, naval guns, I guess by naval support, landing craft, Sherman crabs. And yeah, different unit emblems, everything researched into detail as you usually know it. That's why I like to show it, because otherwise you might miss simply the work that went into it. So we could play right ahead, but I like it to do it this way. Yeah, that is British Airborne. Canadians. Yeah, already a lot of interest here, so if you have any questions or any, you can of course let me know in the chat. Okay, next. The Czechs for the Allies. Now, many of those nations, even when they were occupied, they were assisting the Allies. Germans. Artillery fair. Okay, interesting. Horse artillery. The French, or Free French Army, I guess. I guess German regulars. Wehrmacht. There's a lot of emblems, you know, researching this stuff, that takes some time. More Germans. Luftwaffe. Luftwaffe, you know, Luftwaffe units. They didn't have that many planes anymore to fly around, so many Luftwaffe personnel went filled the role of infantry. Same for Marine, for the naval forces. Netherlands. The Dutch. Norwegians, yeah, they participated in commando raids, one of the, you know, this on the power plant, quite a famous one. The Polish. Yeah, and about options, as you saw, there were many folders with or sometimes folders, but also here, for example, map graphics. You have, for example, hex outline, no hex outline. If you like hexes, or perhaps you don't like hexes, you can yourself copy those files, take them here, and move them into here. You have no hexes. High-res graphic, for people that like it classic, you have the legacy graphics, again with options for hex, no hex. If you think that, that's too much for me, simply play the game. But if you are somebody that likes to modify your game to your liking, check those folders so that you don't miss content. Alexander, hey, I'm new here. I found your channel from Substream. Yeah, welcome, welcome. Great that you found our place. Yeah, sound, sure, you can mod it if you want. Okay, I think that's it. Let's get in the game, but I will run some... I usually like to use my Windows blinds, which is an option to make it a bit Windows stuff, bit, but you don't need to use it. Okay. Good. Yeah, let's close those windows. We don't need them anymore. And yeah, that was basically the overview part. Now we will get to the game. One interesting thing is also, perhaps some might not notice, check really those operations which I presented you. You have, for example, stuff like Market Garden. Yeah, major operations you can play here. Because Market Garden, quite popular. Okay, but yeah, one thing I wanted to show you about this small to big scenarios. Yeah, you have scenarios like this. What I need to check. Yeah, early access will be auto in the tutorial. Yeah, if you have small things like this, and you think, yeah, great, but I like it bigger. Yeah, don't be afraid. And now look at, you can often tell by the turns how big something is. And you know, the game is named, the name, and look at this magnum opus. Yeah, I think no questions asked anymore. This should be big enough for everybody here. The complete operation. This is true operational warfare. Yeah. Okay, but this would be for a tutorial play. It would be a bit too big. But yeah, you can, I guess, what was the turn time? 110 turns or 140 turns. This is really an epic thing. Yeah, if you play this, I don't know, in single player, or you play this hot seat or PBM multi, whatever multiplayer, you really have something you can play for quite a time. Yeah, so safe to say. Good, but we will get into the tutorial. But can I have the start menu again? Okay, let's see. Battle of Merpla, 3rd September 44. I like that the tutorial also comes with a story. 4th 9th West Riding Infantry Division attacks across the Turnhawk Canal, culminating intense close quarters combat at the depot de Mendicite, surrounded by high walls and a moat. This combined prison mental institution present a formidable to obstacle that was only to overcome on the September 29th after the assault by two British infantry battalions. Exhausted, the British handed over the fight to the recently arrived 1st Polled Armored Division. On the morning of the 3rd Rifle Brigade continued the attack to the northeast and soon would encounter stiff resistance at the crossroad town of Merpla. This getting started scenario intended to acquaint new players with the basic of movements, fire and assault. The scenario only covers the first hours of the Polish attack. The two exhausted British battalions around the depot de Mendicite are fixed for the durations of the scenario and have been placed on a map for historical interest only. Yeah, perfect. Sounds fine. Exactly what we are looking for. And according to the document, we will play the Allies, the Polish this time. And the Germans will take over automatic with field of war, fog of war, of course. About rules, nothing is mentioned. You know, you have this here where you can, you or your multiplayer buddy can decide on specific rules. There are some interesting things. Everything is explained in the manual. Check it out. For example, you can take away randomness by basically calculating twice and getting the middle value out of it. Stuff like this. There's a help document here. But yeah, we will play standard. It seems nothing is mentioned. Let's go. Five turns. Yeah, about the vision. So you have three visions. No, it's a smaller map. And you also have a 3D vision and two zoom levels. Can play it in real time, can switch over it from a traditional war game tabletop view to a 3D view side top down. Yeah, let's talk about the interface. You have usual stuff: opening, loading, saving, replay. Then you have some commands like change travel modes, which is, for example, important for AT guns. rail mode, you know, for if you want to transport units in bigger scenarios. You can do stuff like sabotage actions. Go on foot is, I guess, for motorized or mechanized units to get out of transportation or something. Yeah, air missions, artillery is also done, CAS and everything, bridge operations, engineer stuff. Okay, assault, that is when you go into close assault with something and you want to resolve it. Units, which units will arrive, which units did arrive, which units will arrive as reinforcements, which air units will be available. Strength about of your units, your objectives. There are two objectives, you see them on the map. Value 100 victory points. Last command report, in case you skipped it, last weather report. Withdraw, some units might leave the map. Ah yeah, okay. What's here? Yeah, victory calculation, current calculation. Yeah, about this victory calculation, I don't know, perhaps it's here different, but John Tiller Games says sometimes said they have even those tutorial scenarios are designed for competitive play, from what I get. So even those tutorial scenarios are, that is basically design philosophy might be done so two players can play it. So don't wonder if you play the tutorial and face, I don't know, a major defeat or whatever. You didn't do everything wrong or whatever, it is simply... You need to do pretty good, even as a trained player, in order to achieve victory. If you in this by this calculation. Good. Then you have a lot of view modes. Yeah, OOB is interesting, of course. You can activate full screen map to remove this here map contours. Find specific units. You can give AI orders. I still wonder about this. Need to check this out. What this exactly allows you. You can shade. Yeah, always use, I think, visibility, right? Yeah, I think that's what I always use. But you can also, we will talk about this taskbar here. Good, yeah, AI. What I often use is AI firing. Yeah, which will basically, every unit that is capable of fire will fire. That skips you a lot of work. And you can also go full AI on a turn. AI orders, like I said, I think there's something that might help you to, I don't know, give a waypoint and then let the AI do it. And yeah, fast AI processing is if you want to quickly, everything will get really quickly done, but I talked about this, there's those hotkeys F5 to F6, 7, F. 5 to F7 or F8, where you can fine tune. I personally like this more because you don't lose sounds, and in this everything goes very fast without you noticing. If you want a middle solution, use those hotkeys F5 to F7, F8. Check the manual, they should be explained there. Yeah, multiplayer options. Looks like even they have an encryption for multiplayer that is not often seen for PBM games, so nobody can screw around with save games. At least from my understanding. Yeah, settings. Yeah, let's keep Beep on Arrow on, but if you are seasoned, because sometimes since I jumped into a JTS game, but after some time, if you hear this Windows beep, you can get this removed. So let's check out what graphic options you have. Yeah, you can also, if you're not a fan of NATO symbology, you can use graphical, they look quite good in this release. Check also the map and the graphics folders in your installation, might be that there are options provided. I personally like to play with, but this looks really good, this looks good, yeah, I think they are quite detailed. I have a question. Are the World War II submarine games Silent Hunter 3, 4 are good? Are both of them worth playing? Yes, they are. Depending on what you're looking for, which theater. Silent Hunter 5 is also worth it. All three modded are worth it. Good, yeah. Let me get my coffee. So, where was... Here, right? we use the graphical unit icons. Yeah, we will use NATO symbology. Yeah, complete toolbar. Okay, alternative highlighting. Label style. Yeah, we don't see the labels. If there are labels in the map, you can try the setting. Yeah, you can remove the 3D counters if you somebody who plays. Most people play in this mode because it's more clear. But if you want to play in 3D, you can enable a different view of those icons. And yeah, for smaller scenarios, might be can also of course work with the resolution. But we will use those because they are better visible, especially at higher resolutions. Yeah, this here you can move it, I don't know, depending on your style, yeah, depending on your monitor, you can decide to move this on every side of your monitor. And yeah, I think there's also somewhere an option to modify this toolbar here. About all options we talked, you will also find them here. There are players that like to use this more, there are players that use the toolbar, there are players that use hotkeys. Okay. Yeah, we already checked this out. Yeah, this is, what is this, zooming? Yeah, we can also do it with mouse scrolling, okay. What is this button? Divisional markings. Ah, okay, that's the colors here. Yeah, let's play in this. I always like this because it helps you with unit cohesion. Otherwise you don't see which units belong to which. I think that's always good. Okay, yeah, we have two objectives we want to capture. And we have here Polish units. A tank battalion. And yeah, I guess this here exactly fixed units, which are simply there for historical reasons. And yeah, if you check a unit, you can by right click on this here, you can check the unit values. Yeah, hard attack, soft attack, assault values, anti-aircraft capabilities, defense. It also might change depending on what current situation you are. You see the man and the strength, and the morale and fatigue, stuff like this also modeled in the game. Looks like they already saw some action, not are in the best condition anymore, but it needs to be done. Okay, next. The tutorial says you should use this here. Yeah, this is, this is of course also good. It indicates you how far a unit can go. It's always interesting with the movement points it has before it has to halt. Okay. So we want to get those units here. Yeah, the mud conditions. It is currently mud. And this is hampering movement. Okay. Yeah, the British unit is not movable, but those two can be moved. Let's get the tanks and the Polish infantry here towards the objective. Germans are already uncovered from the 719th Infantry Division elements. Yeah, while movement you might receive of course fire, caused fatigue, stress. Fatigue is basically a term for that sums up stress and everything. And I was able to get the northern objective by a desperate assault in the last turn, so it will be again a hard tutorial cover. So you already checked out this game. Yeah, welcome. Perhaps you can then help me if I might struggle with something. Good, yeah, we have those units here. I guess next we will move this stack. Except for the British. You can also double click. But yeah, need to deselect the British because they are out of battle. And I guess those guys are reserve. Some, what is it? Stewards and German fireflies, yeah, could be that makes sense, keeping fireflies in reserve. They are not that good in an anti-emplacement, anti-infantry role. They are for anti-tank. In case some German tanks appear, we can react, and stewards can do some scouting. Are they fixed anyways? Yeah, okay, I see it, yeah. The Polish, okay, we have expanded all our movement points, but artillery units are available to fire. Yeah, artillery is handled quite straightforward here in this game. You press here, every available artillery unit will show here, and you can simply select them and immediately fire. I like this, it is not complicated, you don't need to do 10,000 clicks or whatever. Okay, three available artillery, that is, Yeah, I guess we will focus on the southern units first. Yeah. Are we supposed to fire all? I guess so. Yeah, you know, even if it doesn't turn out, I already sometimes played those tutorials without going step by step. If you're new, do it. But this makes sense always to focus on a single objective. Okay, they're asking us, I guess those guns are more important to bombard. Wait, let's quickly check what is the status of them. Are they somehow dug in? We have no information. We only know the guns are Roman numbers indicate approximates 10 guns, 1 to 10, and this can be from 100 to 1000 men. But it looks like it is a company element or something sitting there. Would make more sense. Okay. Perhaps let's check again. What is this even firing here? Medium. Okay. Yeah, let's alternate. Okay, yeah, some guys got hit. It's not only about neutralizing, it's also about suppressing and everything. At least cause some fatigue, that's good. Just keep in mind, getting started sometimes requires luck to be successful, not a lot of time to devise strategy. Yeah, like I said, those getting started scenarios, they are also designed for being quite challenging, quite competitive, so don't wonder if you're in a tutorial, you don't manage to get through it. Just don't stare only on the victory screen. Rubber improved position for 50% defense modifier, yeah, exactly. Okay, artillery expanded. We have some units in close vicinity. Let's see what is the next in this tutorial. Yeah, we did it. You can check our unit's artillery range. Yeah, sure. Let's do it here. Where is it shown? What? Is that the window? By pressing right click on the unit box, units range, artillery units range. It's somewhere shown here, I know. I think it is, yeah, is it one of those here, 16, I think so, 16 tiles, yeah, 16 hexes, good, next, what is this, okay, we are ready with our first turn. Yeah, Germans count off. Attacking, firing, not attacking, count firing. Firing and movement are two pair of shoes here. You can assault, which is a really deliberate thing you not want to consider, and you can exchange fire. Exchanging fire is also something you might need to consider. You know, if you fire, you can also get hit. If you try to hit something, it can also hit you, probably. So it's always advisable to fire holes into the air. A German machine gun might notice you and tear you down. Okay, exactly. Let's use those keys. I will show you. I think F7 is the button that makes it faster. Or is it F6? Want to speed it up a bit up? F8? Yeah, oh shit, that was too fast. Okay, yeah, but it is F7, I guess it's an acceleration button. F8 is maximum acceleration. F6 is slower, F5 is slowest, as I remember. And you can get some stuff. I like the sounds in the game, and for me sounds are important. For me is audio is important. I hate to play, no matter if it is a map game, where I hear nothing. And so you can use... Ah, yeah, that was now activated because of F8. But we will deactivate it and I'll show you the fine-tuning. That is really a beautiful feature. You can play fast, but without losing those audio-visual information. Good, next turn. Skip the command report, I think, yeah, but we can check it again. Okay, one HQ is out of command. I guess that's a British one. 2 units low on ammo. Nobody's broken. 2 units recovered fatigue, 1 unit recovers some losses, good. Okay, let's see, at the start of the turn, Okay. Yeah, let's examine, the tutorial says we should examine our frontline units. Yeah, some tanks are disrupted, several units low on ammo, fatigue is piling up, but it is okay. Fatigue is not a number of percentage, what is it? But I think those numbers, it's mentioned in the manual, I forgot it about, but there is a value that it will also show you visually. Green is okay, yellow becomes not problematic, it is already problematic, red is absolutely horrendous. So even if those numbers might be abstract to you, look at the colors. Yeah, yellow for example, 47%, not the best condition. And same for fatigue. I think if it goes yellow, red, you know, problems. Okay. Okay, all of our units have full movement. Have full movement points and you should use these to fire on the enemy or assault. Yeah, that is good advice, thank you. To fire, first click on a Polish stack. Yeah, I guess those tanks should fire and the infantry should assault. Is that an idea? I don't... What is this? There's a pile of rubble since I'm placed. Yeah, rubble. I don't think I want to drive as a tank into a rubble position. Click on the move fire button. Wasn't that control? Ah, that is the move fire button. Yeah, you can also use the control quickly to switch between firing and moving. Here. I think you can also fire on tiles, recon by fire, or whatever you want to call it. Fire by praying, spraying. Okay, yeah. They leave us a lot of freedom to handle this. So we will focus on this tile. I think the vehicles will focus with firing while the infantry might assault. Yeah, I don't see much reason to use this. We absolutely don't know anything. They have anti-tank guns there. Sitting there, I definitely won't move my tanks into this. And we have absolutely, I don't know if this is even a good idea to assault. We have no information about their condition. They could be completely fine and awaiting us. But okay, let's handle first, let's do some firing. I better save in case something went wrong. Okay, let's go. Yeah, do I want to target those AT guns? That is a good question. I mean, sure, right? Primary target. Yeah, we got one gun. Better than nothing. Let's hit more of those guns. Because they could prove up. Did we lose a vehicle? No. Movement is okay. Yeah, one gun. And about 10 casualties. You didn't see how much casualties, but 1 to 10. Okay, we're doing some work here with those Cromwells and Fireflies. Okay, this gun, this tank is fire, has expanded. It's not sure, do I want to expand the ammunition? But yeah, let's do it. Okay, nothing happened. We lost some men, unfortunately, but no vehicles. Basically, accompanying infantry. So I want to... Nah, they are fixed anyways. Okay. Yeah, so I need to think... I guess it is explained, right? I did already many assaults, but like I said, some time since I played this. You can initiate assaults exactly with several units, and then you can execute it. And for assault, you press this here. I guess you press simply on a tile, like as you would like to move into this, but better save in case something goes wrong. Good. Yeah, okay, but nothing happened yet. You can also cancel it. I think you lost some movement points. You basically said prepare. And if you come back and say, nah, I changed my mind, you might lose movement points, but we will go in. I don't think it's a good idea. I don't feel good about this. It doesn't feel really prepared, but... Let's see what happens. It is a tutorial, not a show how good you can do it. And we will follow the tutorial by the book here. Okay, now you see those two blinking units. I think they're both basically participating in this assault. The assault is planned by two infantry units. One thing I should perhaps kept in mind is at least one... But yeah, if you participate, I think as tank units in an assault, they will really try to drive into it. But you might leave some ammunition for them in order so they can counterfire. But I'm not sure about the best tactics here. And then you press resolve assault. And we managed it. We managed it. They even... Yeah, I think this means we lost 17 defenses, I think, on the second... We lost 17, they lost 5. And they... retreated. So okay, this worked out. They are disrupted. There was even a second unit, it seems. Okay. Who are these guys? Volks. Total assault with low ammo troops. It reduced our assault by 50% or something. Yeah, but we have the Polish bonus here. Now I get what you see, what you mean. That's exactly what I was also question the order. You normally don't want to attack never with or try to prevent attacking with low ammunition, with disrupted or I mean disrupted can't attack anyways. Yeah, you know, simply a unit that assaults needs to be in good condition, but here we have nothing and we had those guys suppressed and got them out. This will now prove to be a challenge. This guy can't move right now. Yeah. And those are fixed. Will they become available? Yeah, they will become available at... Wait, where was the turn again? At 12 o'clock. Currently it is... Where was the... 10 o'clock. In 2 turns, those tanks will be available for a last push, because then my turns are almost over. Yeah, I guess it will become a last push. Perhaps we will do nothing right now, recover, and fire artillery on those guys, start to shell them. Yeah, that's what I forgot, to shell them. On the other hand, perhaps it was even better. I mean, we lost really not many, of course, we lost people there, which paid the ultimate price. But now we can use the artillery on... I would immediately fire the artillery on here, but I forgot about it. But it is basically luck. We can now use the artillery on this, because I think this objective will become way more severe. Yeah. Yeah, fire... on those guns... Alter. Yeah, perfect. One gun destroyed. Every AT gun has the capability of taking out several tanks or even infantry. Yeah, perfect. Very good hits here. Yeah, but it's more about the psychological effect, the cohesion effect. Except for those guns. Yeah, perfect. Three guns taken out. That is really a good result here. And I mean, those guns, we shouldn't take them. What is this? Looks like an infantry gun, but infantry guns can also be extremely, can be dangerous to vehicles. Perhaps it can fire heat. You know, for some of those older infantry guns, the Germans developed some heat solutions. Heat doesn't require a high velocity. It is even for the Monroe effect. It requires a certain lower velocity. That's why heat charges are rather slow. And yeah, it could be that they have something for this. And a heat charge can knock out every tank in the Allied equipment arsenal. Good, yeah, this guy might try to move over. I don't know, I think not moving into the rubble. Nah, let's combine them. Oh, that's still this turn. Yeah, I need to. Okay, let's see what. Yeah, turn three. This is finishing. And then the next tutorial will start, but the rest we can play free. Could, of course, hit the auto fire, see if something happens. On the other hand, no need. Nobody needs to fire. I will get hit, shell those guys. Mike, prepare for. What's the problem? Yeah, speeding up. F7. Is it F7? Yeah, you see, it is now speeding up. Yeah, that is, for example, for me, a complete fine speed. Yeah, a bit slower to see to see better the casualties. Yeah, perfect. And with F7, F6, you can fine-tune it without losing sounds, but still have a high speed. Now, compared to the slowest speed, that is quite slow. Yeah. That is the slow speed. F5 slow speed, F6 fine tune low, F7 5 fine tune high, F8 max speed. But we will again go with F7. You need really a lot of hits. Otherwise, it's simply too slow. Yeah, perfect. Now we have a speed here. I still can read all information. I have sounds. I don't need to wait 10 seconds for something happening. Need to get going for online class. Have fun with Sheld. It's pretty good. I watch the rest of the live stream later. Okay, have good success in your class, Carla. Okay, you disrupted. 2 units recovered. That's the third turn. I have 5 turns, right? So I want to prepare for one ultimate attack, I guess. While the tanks and artillery will shell those guys, in the last turn, we will bring everything. Yeah, you guys recover. First, Arti. Air, we don't have air. Here is the air dialogue. It works similar to the Arti dialogue. Oh, what is this? This means, I guess, those guys are not in the best condition anymore. That is good. Yeah, they are disrupted. Perfect. Keep them hitting until we get them. Very good. Another gun destroyed. Yeah, fatigue is also good. Give them, suppress them, give them the complete psychological pressure. Good, tanks the same, fire, HE. And those disrupted guys, I don't think they can fire. Oh, they can. Oh, wait. Okay. Cancel assault! David. Okay, but nothing happened. I can cancel the assault. We exchange fire. It was here somewhere. Assault is cancelled. But you see, you pay a price. Basically, I said prepare for assault. They moved into positions, had exchanges with the Germans. Perhaps they lost their vehicle, doesn't look like. They got disrupted. And yeah, that was not planned. I had forgot to press control. So let's continue. It's shelling them. Yeah, focus on the guns. Okay. Those guys, they will recover and replenish the ammo. Ah, they are available now. Okay, okay, that's good. Show me the tiles I can move into. Okay, we could get here, right? Then we have... This is... Now we have even two turns then. So we can really put a lot of pressure on those guys. Yeah, you can move one by one by right-clicking. You can also, in this case, perhaps we will do it one by one. You can also by left-dragging move quickly. And with shift left-dragging, you can move entire units around. But I might do it. On the other hand, I don't know what is the fastest way. Sometimes it can trigger some, I guess. We don't want to move through the bunker. Perfect. Yeah, I should have checked the hex, but it's okay. Is there something here? Is a hex? If you right click, you can see what is. Always check this. Is information quickly missed? For example, a stream. You see it on the map here. Let's see if there's some hint, some barricades. On this tile, secondary, primary, secondary. I guess this is something. A road, secondary road, I guess. Okay, they can't fire because they were busy with moving. Good. Perhaps the fireflies were not necessary. Normally you want to keep fire, but I guess I don't expect any German tanks, but who knows. Surprise counterattack. Yeah. Artillery I fired already, right? No, you stay here. You are the HQ of whom? There is a button for it. I mean, they belong together, yeah. Yeah, I guess get closer. Is this something? There's, you want to keep HQs close to your units, otherwise they might face penalty. I'm not sure if they are in contact. Could be that the next turn they might get out of contact. There's something like HQ range somewhere here. Whatever, he can still, he can anyways move only one, but this could be because he is triggered not to use his vehicle. We can use the vehicle, but he might lose contact range when he is. But whatever, let's test it out. Travel mode was... What was travel mode again? For button or icon. Here. T, you see this T here? Means transport. Now they are motorized. Didn't change much because for this motorized action, they already spent a lot of points. But next turn we can immediately get towards the tanks. But it could be, I'm not exactly sure, that motorization, you know, they have radios, you know, command, they need to deploy everything, they need to set everything up. And by telling them to motorize, they might lose the capability to stay in contact with their unit. So we will see. Yeah, I on purpose didn't fire with those guys in order to recover them. As I said, you don't always want to use your complete fire. Some units that are scheduled for assaulting, I try to give them always maximum rest before we will go for it. Give them complete firepower. Very good. Two guns destroyed. Thirty-two vehicles. Well, not bad. Give them some HE. Very good. Another one on those guns. What is the gun? Below ten guns. Yeah, come on, those guys are disrupted. Disrupted. Yeah, but I think those guns are no problem. If disrupted guns, they don't really do anything that much more. Perhaps you want to get those infantry even more suppressed. But yeah, let's don't change the working plan. Good. One question is, if I move both infantry units completely into this tile, there's even one unit disappeared. It's simply not, either they moved, I guess we would have noticed, but in the woods, might be that you don't see them in the woods. Okay, I think one single unit can handle it, because I need to leave a rear guard. But what we will do with the other unit is suppressive fire. So let's check out, those are Morale D, Morale Fatigue 25. Yeah, those guys will attack the 44th, the first. You guys give suppressive fire. Germans firing out of the bushes. Nothing we can't handle. Okay. Let's see if we can assault this objective. Good. One guy was shot. Another guy was shot while preparing the assault. Ready? Go. Yes! Objectives taken. Good. Counterattack. Currently, I don't see any that they will immediately take it back. Next turn, we can move, I don't know, the stewards perhaps into the town. And that's it. And shell them. But those guys are not. If there must be something new coming. So I think this is a bit more easier. This finally, John Tiller Games, thanks you for. for some manageable tutorial scenarios where you're not getting blasted. At least it seems. If you do everything by the book, you should do it. Should succeed. Okay, is there anything I... Those guys in theory could fire. Yeah, let's use auto fire in order to get them away from us. AI firing means every unit that can fire will fire. Yeah, one guy was shot while trying to retreat. Good. But on the other hand, Na, ammo is fine currently, right? You had some time to replenish. Okay. Yeah, looks like they're still, but it's only firing. It's only firing, and rather ineffective. And they're not assaulting. They're just firing back, and without effect. Almost no effect. Okay, now I will activate full speed mode. And you see, that's extremely fast. That's a full speed mode if you want to get really fast through a turn, because there's not much to expect it to happen. Yeah, we can, of course, because every casualty is counted as victory points. Those guys are sitting basically in the open, right? Yeah. So we can hit them hard with tanks. They're still, I mean, that's not some destroyed unit, right? They are still numbered from 100 to 1000. It's not some guys that are not important. Let's get the complete tank unit over here. Not sure if we have capabilities to fire afterwards. Let's see. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense. They only hit us with AT gun, AT weaponry. Reachable hexes. Where was it again? Here. I don't know if this is any good. Could move into the town, but that would be quite. And then we might fire. Yeah, it's just it out. Normally, I would call it that day. I don't know if we can move really that much units into the. Nah, that was useless. We can't fire. Because it's rubble. Moving tanks into rubble is. But yeah, the stewards, Firefly, stay here. And yeah, there will not much will happen. I mean, I forgot about artillery. Of course, can especially those guys in the open we will hit. Those guys are also in the open. Mhm. Yeah. So those two units, those guys are in forest. So that's it. Those units in the open. Let's focus one artillery unit on one unit. I guess there's some effect that they can, you know, home in with additional fire. Okay, that's it. Okay, they're still fighting. And some. Okay, now the time is. Major victory! Okay, yeah. I mean, yeah, that's the losses. Axis really lost a lot. I guess the artillery was extremely effective in the tank fire. They lost 15 guns. And 230 men. Allies lost 40. Okay, can I see the map? Yeah. And yeah, what I really like is that JTS went a bit more easy on those tutorial scenarios. That is good, because like I mentioned, I'm, you know, it's absolutely fine, because but past games, they were quite hard to achieve. As I mentioned, as perhaps those scenarios were really designed for PBM or something in mind, that even a tutorial could become really hard to win, at least when it comes to victory points. Okay, yeah, that's it. That was the when the enemy is outnumbering you, should be taking chances to assault them. Yeah, it depends. Outnumbering is a stretch term. It depends on the situation. Even an outnumbered enemy can absolutely inflict severe losses on you. I mean, the Germans always fought outnumbered, basically. You should need to pay attention for stuff like defense, in what condition they are, what weapons they bring. Quantity alone is, of course, it is a factor, but those things like 3-1 or whatever, in this game it is a bit more complex. You should pay attention to details like fortifications, weaponry, equipment, morale, fatigue, terrain, as in reality. Okay, yeah, that's it. That was an overview of Scheldt 44. Really enjoyed the scenario. And yeah, check it out. Yeah, and thanks to JTS. Okay, see you.